Hi everyone, today we are going to learn what is collection framework in Java, what is collection framework in Java and why we need collection framework in Java. Collection framework, it is a group of classes and interfaces. Collection framework mainly contains 9 key interfaces. One is collection, second is list, third one is set, and fourth is queue. And fifth is sorted set and navisable set, map, sorted map and navisable map. Why we need collection framework? Collection is used to store a group of elements into a single entity, but we have already array in Java that can store multiple objects into a single variable. We have already an array to store group of elements, then why we need collection? Because array have few limitations, and to overcome these limitations we need collection. Because if we declare once a size inside array, then we cannot increase or decrease according to our requirement, and array can store only homogeneous element and heterogeneous objects are not allowed. So to overcome the arrays problem, collection was come. And main advantage of collection framework is this: it is growable in size and we can store both homogeneous and heterogeneous elements, but in array we can store only homogeneous elements. To overcome arrays problem, we need collection framework, and collection framework mainly contains 9 key interfaces, and these 9 key interfaces have multiple implementation classes. And so first we will learn about what is collection interface and what it will do. Collection interface is the root interface of our all interfaces. It is a collection interface and it is a root interfaces of all interfaces, and it contains all the common method that we need for all interfaces, and there is no any class that can directly implement our collection interface. And what is why we need collection interface? It is a root interface of collection framework that defines common method which are applicable for any collection object, and there is no concrete class which can directly implement our collection interface. Collection framework contains one class, that's name is collections. So there is one main interview Java question: what is the difference between collection and collections? What is the difference between collection and collections? What is the difference between collection and collections? Collection is an interface that is a root interface of all interfaces in collection framework, and it contains all the common method that we need for all interfaces and we can use for every collection object. But collections is an class. Collections, it is a class that contains a utility method so we can perform searching and sorting operation firstly. So there is one method collections dot sort and multiple more methods inside collections class. And there is second interface is list interface. Why we need list interface? If we want to store a group of objects into a single entity, then we can use list interface. If we use list interface, we need to store duplicate elements and we need insertion order must be preserved, then we should go for list interface. List interface is used if you want to store a group of objects into a single entity, and insertion order must be preserved and duplicates are allowed. Then we should go for list interface. Set interface if we want to store a group of objects into a single entity where duplicates are allowed and insertion order duplicates are not allowed and insertion order not preserved. Then we should go for set interface. And what is the difference between list and set interfaces? And list we can use if we need duplicates and insertion order must be preserved. Then we should go for list, and set where duplicates are not allowed and insertion order will not be preserved. It is the main difference between list and set interfaces. Q. If you want to store a group of object into a single entity and where we want to perform prior to processing, then we should go for queue. Queue perform FIFO operation. First in, first out. Then we can use queue. The queue we can use in, for example, if you want to send a mail to multiple persons, first we will store the mails of all person inside two address, and in which order we save this email ID in the same order we want to send, then we can use queue concept. And fourth one is sorted set interfaces. And so when we need to use sorted set interfaces, if you want to store a group of objects into a single entity, if sorted set is a child interface for set interface, so duplicates will not be allowed. And if we want where duplicates are not allowed and we want sorting order, if we want sorting order, then we should go for sorted set, because set will not allow duplicates and it will allow sorting order. Then we should go for sorting set interface. And sixth one is sort navigable map. And navigable map is used to perform navigable operation. And the implementation classes for sorted set and navigable set is the tree set. Tree set contains only homogeneous objects because it provides sorting order to our classes. And queue have multiple child classes. Queue has priority queue, another one is blocking queue. And blocking queue have two childs, priority blocking queues and linked blocking queues. And the next one is map. Map is another part and collection is another. Both are interfaces and independent to each other. When we should go for map? If you want to store group of object in key value form, then we should go for map. If we want to store a group of object as a key value pair, then we should go for map. Duplicate keys are not allowed, but we can store duplicate values. And map interfaces have multiple child classes that implements map interface. One is hash map, another one is linked hash map, and every class has own properties. Another one is identity hash map, weak hash map, sorted map, navigable map. And the implementation classes for sorted map and navigable map is tree map. And there is one dictionary class, hash table class, and property classes. And every class has own properties. Okay, thanks.